Hello friends, we'll be understanding one concept, or rather the last concept of average due date, whereby we have to figure out the calculation of average due date when interest on drawings is charged. So what exactly do we mean by drawings? Drawings basically is that time or regular time intervals when amount is withdrawn from the capital account of the partners. So when the partners have a specific amount in their businesses, or rather which we call as capital accounts, if you withdraw a certain amount from that on regular intervals, or maybe during certain emergencies or any such case that may be possible. So during such scenario, or while that is happening, in that case you have to charge interest on such specific things. So when the amount is withdrawn by the business people, or rather the businessmen, during regular time intervals or whenever the case of emergency is, that amount of withdrawn, or rather the amount that is withdrawn, is known as drawing. Now this withdrawal will happen at every regular interval. Maybe like in the month of April you did that, in the month of June, in the month of August, in the month of October, November, December, whichever it may be. So the business is entitled to receive certain interest on it, because you're taking off the amount from the business now, and hence that is the kind of interest that will be charged on certain drawings. So you can figure out the interest date, because if you take out those drawings on regular intervals, it will be a little tedious job for you guys to understand how much interest is supposed to be charged for every drawing. So in that case, the withdrawals can be done n number of times. You can settle off the payment at one specific time itself. So what will happen is that if you do withdrawals at n number of times, there will be one certain point where you can pay off all that liability, and the interest will be accumulated only till that date itself. So just like the way we did it in the previous video, whereby interest was calculated on repayments here, so the same thing can be done here, and average due date concept can be utilized to figure out the average due date where the payment can be made and the interest will be charged only until that time frame, because that will be the break-even point here. So how do we do that is something that we'll understand now. Let's draw down certain points for your reference. It will help you for your better understanding. Now the point ACS have been mentioned, let's read it out for your reference. Drawings are basically the amount that is withdrawn on regular intervals, or maybe any time interval. If there are amounts that are due on different dates, you can also make sure that the amount is paid off on one specific day as well. Now to assess this, we have average due date calculation that can be utilized here. The interest part, or rather the interest calculation on such average due date system, can be also done using this specific system that we have been using for the past three methods. Now to give you a rough example for this, we'll be doing an illustration in the next video which will help you understand how the interest is supposed to be calculated, both in the ordinary system that we do and in the average due date system. And average due date system will also have certain scenarios whereby if we take the average due date, or rather the base date as the start date, or rather the base date as the start date of some other thing or something like this, will be mentioned there. But for your reference, we'll do an illustration which will have an ordinary system in the place as well and the average due date system in place as well, so that you can compare it both by both, or rather side by side, for your better understanding. So I hope this video has given you a clarity about what exactly we'll be doing when it comes to interest, or rather the interest on drawing being a part of average due date calculations. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.